I don't know what it is about today, but today is just not my day. I am sleepy. I took two naps. For no reason. Well, there is a reason. There was. I was sleepy, you know? Mentally tired, not really exhausted, just... I laid down, and I was out. For like 30 minutes, maybe an hour for the second one. I don't know. But honestly, I could go back to sleep right now. And so I picked up the lovely Monster, you know, Monster, hey, give me a call, sponsor me, because I drink Monsters every day. Honestly, you would think, as much as I like Alphalete clothing, and I do, you know, I'm practically wearing Alphalete over Gymshark nowadays. Gymshark, I don't know, it's just their clothes, they're not as great as they used to be. Maybe they are now, recently, I haven't checked them out in a while. But back to the energy drink, you would think I would be drinking 3D energy drinks. Or their, is that what they're called now? Up Energy, 3D Energy. The white ones, which are supposed to be the ones that are competing with the White Monster. And I've had it. You know, I've had it a couple times. And I don't know why, but I just prefer the White Monster over the 3D Energy drinks. They just taste better. Damn, it's already 8 o'clock. Maybe my nap was a lot longer than I thought, because damn. I'm here late. Like, normally I'm here around, like, 7:30. Well, it's my usual time, actually, because I wouldn't start working out until, like, 9. Now I'm getting my workout in earlier. Maybe 30 minutes, an hour earlier. You know, getting a feel for it. But damn. I didn't realize it was already 8. So, today's going to be a push day. Is that right? Push day? We're going to see how well I'm able to do because of my elbow. I found this video online by Squat University. I bought his book. It's been great so far. And I did one or two of the exercises that I was able to do. I didn't have all the tools, so I was only able to do a few things. And I'm hoping that has helped out by 5, maybe 10%, enough to make this workout more bearable, you know? At least that's what I hope. I don't know if that's gonna be true, but hopefully I'm not feeling any pain when I'm doing the incline press. Decline, is it decline, incline? I don't know, whatever. But hopefully I'm not feeling any pain. Hopefully I'm able to go heavy. Hopefully I'm able to push myself as much as I want to progress by one more rep compared to last time that I do that exercise, you know? Because that's how we're going to progress, just by one more rep. Ideally more, but if we cannot do more, we have to push ourselves to do one more rep than last time. Which is why I always advocate to tracking your workouts. Because if you're not tracking your workouts, you're not sure, you're not going to know if you're making progress, you know? So you always want to beat the numbers from last time. If you go in here and do a couple exercises, whatever, sure, some people can progress. Don't get me wrong. Some people can see progress by coming in here, just working out and not tracking. I'm not one of those people. And I'm sure if those people would track, they probably would get better results. I'm not telling them what to do. I'm just saying, hey, it makes logical sense. You know, but maybe they're doing something different that I should be doing that I didn't do. But I just know tracking the workouts does wonders. Let me tell you. I actually saw a picture of myself from 2020. Man, was I a skinny bitch. Whew. I weighed like 170, maybe 180 back in 2020. I'm weighing like 230 now. 4 years. I put on a decent amount of muscle, a lot more fat, unfortunately, because I got a remote job, and just having a desk job, it did not go so well for the gaining weight portion. Of course. The first exercise that I was supposed to do was taken up, and now that I'm over here, they left it, so, all right. It's not that big of a deal. This is actually not even the exercise that I'm supposed to be doing. I'm supposed to be doing the crossbody Y raises. Actually, what are those? Because it might be confusing it for something else. I 100% am. So I have 100 pounds on here, like I normally have for the past couple weeks. My goal is to do 12 reps. I'm able to do 12 reps for one set. Now it's time to get the other two sets to 12 reps. It's nowhere near 12 reps. There's absolutely no reason why I should not be able to do 12 reps. I've done it before. Last time I trained shoulders and did this exercise was on Sunday, and I kind of failed at that when I bombed it out. So there, I should be able to do 12 reps today. Like, I should ideally be recovered. I know I can do 12 reps. I've done it before, so I should be able to do it again. That wasn't the 12 reps, but it was 11. That's closer than the first time. Way closer. And fuck, man. What's going on? I understand not being able to do it last time because it was really hot in here. I was sweating. Like, I did not feel good physically because of the heat. You know, I was practically having a heat stroke. Today, there's no excuse. There's absolutely no excuse. I might do an extra set to push myself and get that extra progressive overload. Normally I only do 3 working sets, but I think I might make this a special occasion to really push myself, add an extra amount of stimulus by doing one more set. So 4 working sets. On the last set, I don't care how many reps I get. I think it's more going to be on the technique and really perfecting it, because maybe something in my technique is off. So I'm going to do an extra set. Maybe I just need some extra progressive overload by doing more. I don't know. I don't know what it is. But I need to do something, because this is 2 days in a row I'm doing a shoulder press that I can't do 100 for 12. Even though I've done it before, but I can't do it again. There's no excuse for it. Enough with the rest period. Let's do this third set out of 4. I honestly thought I was going to be able to do 12 reps. I thought I had the last one, but as soon as I started going down, I knew it was going to be impossible for me to push it back up. Overall, looking at the numbers from this week and last week, or the previous time I did this, I'm only 2 reps of a difference. You know, same weight, just the number of reps. I should have been able to do 2 more reps overall, which is why I'm doing an extra set. The extra set's basically just going to be for me to overload the muscle. It's hard to explain how my mind works on this, but ideally, like, my muscle is used to doing X amount of weight for those 3 sets, right? And only 3 sets. So by doing an extra set, I'm giving it a different amount of stimulus, you know, breaking it down slightly more. That over in the long run should help. But that's just my train of thought. I'm not sure how long my rest period's been. But I'm gonna go ahead and do this last set. It's an extra set, so I'm not too worried about it. I'm hoping I can do another 11 reps. That's gonna be ideal. But since I'm only, 2-3 reps shy from the last time I did this exercise, I'm gonna make sure that I do more than that. So at least 4 reps minimum, ideally, you know, closer to like the 10 rep range. I'm still gonna push myself to failure because that's when the actual muscle is gonna grow and adapt, going to failure. So just because this is an extra set does not mean I'm gonna take it easy on myself. It's gonna be the hardest one because I'm already tired and sore, at least my shoulders are. So we're gonna make the shoulders even more. Fuck. I don't think my rest period was that long. Jesus Christ. Only 6 reps. Alright. It's the better than nothing.
I realized that last time I was supposed to do this exercise, I actually ended up doing something completely different. And that is my fault because I didn't look up the video.
Out of all the exercises that I do, this one's like a fairly new exercise, and I'm actually surprised at how strong I am on this machine. You know, it's on par to what I've normally done. I've done, I think, the max of 10 reps, did 9. I'm sure I could have done one more if I pushed myself. Maybe warmed up a little bit more. But for the next set, pretty sure like doing 10 reps, 11 reps, is going to be easier than this first set. You know, I always said I was tired when I got here, sleepy, but I feel like the caffeine finally has kicked in, the monster, after an hour. And man, I'm like jittery, moving around, shaking. Feeling pretty good. Pretty fucking good. It's so weird how this gym gets busy and dead. It's never a linear thing like I've seen at most gyms. It's sporadic. Random people come in here, which is good, you know, the guests. But they all come at once.
like they're all together, but they're not. And then the normal people that are here, they're either here or they're not here. And it's kind of odd. So, but honestly, this is a really great gym. It's got everything I need. It's got some great people. You know, a lot of people that I like to talk to are here. Just hang out with, you know, hang out with you guys in the little lobby area for about an hour. Chill, whatever. And it's honestly a very peaceful gym. Gets kind of busy, kind of hectic, but I mean, that's gonna be like almost any single gym. You can tell that the monster finally kicked in, because I'm like in a good mental space. Earlier when I came in here, man, I was just like dreading this workout, but like right now I'm like, I'm having a good time. Taking my time, working out, you know, just chilling, pushing myself. I don't even know how many exercises that I have left. Actually, you know, I should check. Because I've only done three exercises. Wow. I've only done three exercises, and it's already been like an hour since I started working out, an hour and a half maybe. But I like to give myself like a good amount of rest period between my sets. And sometimes I get lost in that rest period because I'm on TikTok or talking to somebody or texting my girlfriend back or snapping somebody. I don't know. You know, I get lost in my rest period. And I'm not complaining about it, like I enjoy it. But if it's like on TikTok, then I get annoyed because I just get lost in TikTok, you know? It's just like mindlessly scrolling. But this is what it is. Next up we have the katanas and the ab curls. So I have two exercises left. The ab curls, I'm not sure if I'm gonna do those. I might do some ab crunches. I should do them. Summer's coming. I need to have some better structured abs. The last exercise was basically pretending I'm putting pulling a sword out of my hip. Now this next exercise is like pulling two swords out of my back. So these katanas are gonna be the best thing for my triceps. I'm pretty sure it's getting that long head that's really difficult to get. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure I'm like 90% right. I forgot to check how many reps I could do. Yeah, well. Four. It's just these extra 5-pounders like change the distribution of the weight, so it's not like not even, and it's like adding more friction to it, which is making it difficult to move smoothly. There we go. One. It's way easier. I'm gonna have to try that one more time because it just wasn't moving the way I wanted it to. Let's move this up a little bit. Make it easier to grab, you know? But we're gonna count that as like 8 reps. I could do more. Oh, the most I've ever done is 40 pounds. Screw it, why not? I'll do 40 again. And I want to beat 12 reps. We'll have to get 40 for 12 reps for 3 sets straight for me to go up in weight. So even if I can do more than 12, I'm gonna stop at 12. conserve my energy for the next couple sets. That actually felt a lot better than the first set. I love it. We're making some moves out here. That workout was a lot better than I thought. The shoulder press was probably the only thing that I hated about today. And not because I don't like that exercise. It's one of my favorite shoulder exercises to do. It's the fact that I was not able to do the amount of reps that I've done in the past. That's what I didn't like about it. There's no reason why I shouldn't be able to do 12 reps, even though I've done it before. I should have been able to do it today. I got close, but it just wasn't there. You know? But I guess to make progress, we have to take a step back a little bit to, you know, correct ourselves. Maybe something was off. Maybe my technique was off. Mentally, maybe I just wasn't there, even though I was. Maybe the caffeine hadn't kicked in yet. And if it did, that might have made a huge difference. But you know what? Maybe I have not recovered yet from Sunday's workout, which... it's been 3 days. I should be recovered, but I also thought about it, and my calves are still sore from training them on Sunday. So, I mean, I guess it's possible that my shoulders were not at 100%. But you know what? That could be a factor. And that could be because I have not had enough protein in my diet, because considering the supplements that I'm taking... whether they're still not a lot, that should help me repair my muscles faster, but they cannot repair my muscles faster if they don't have the amino acids, the protein that it needs to repair. So that's on me. You know, I know I have not had enough protein, but luckily tomorrow is going to, well, I don't know if tomorrow's going to be a rest day. Depending on how I feel, I might go in there and train legs, or I might take it as a rest day. I probably should take it as a rest day. That way I consume more protein and my body repairs everything that it needs. And it's only utilizing it to repair what's been broken and not trying to play catch up, you know? So I like to think about the intake of protein as a car, you know? You drive your car, you waste gas, you stop and you fill it up, right? And if you think about it, you drive your body, work out, that's the driving portion, and you stop, which is your rest day, and fuel up. You recover, right? And then you're ready to go. Now, if we constantly train and don't consume enough protein, you're like driving and getting gas at the same time. It's great in theory because you don't have to stop, but at the same time, it's just going. It's this giant circle. Like, you don't know if you're getting enough protein in there because it's constantly being utilized. Your tank is never full of protein or of gas. So it's always like trying to play catch up. And that's just the way I see it. I don't know if it's the best analogy, but you know what? Taking a rest day allows my body to go back to being at 100%, meaning a full tank of gas, and recovered. So depending on how I feel tomorrow, it's either going to be a rest day or it's not going to be a rest day. It's going to be a leg day. So we'll see how that is. And you know what? People might say, just take a scoop of pre-workout, drink another Monster, have some caffeine, and go do your workout. Stop being a little bitch, you know? And it's nothing about not being, you know, being a little bitch about, you know, not working out, taking a rest day. Like, rest days are important. They really are. We may not like doing them. We might still go to the gym and do something, but they are a key thing to do to recover. You know, the amount, no matter how much pre-workout I take, no matter how much caffeine I consume, my body still needs to recover. Now, taking the enhancements
that I'm taking, which again, it's not a lot, I'm able to recover, let's say, 10% faster than I would have without them. So, but if I'm not giving my body the appropriate amount of fuel, then I'm just wasting it. So, I'm gonna have a protein shake right before I go to sleep, which is gonna give me, so it's 50-50 and then that, like 60, 70 grams of protein, somewhere in that. And I should be at like a minimum of 200 grams for the day. I know I had like 10 ounces of beef and then I had another 10 ounces of beef and that was, I think, like 115. I had some chicken, don't know how much it was, but I think it was like 3-4 ounces with some rice. I'm not like mentally counting that, but with, well, I am counting that, I guess. So that should put me at like over 200 grams of protein, which is pretty decent. A guy my size, which is, I'm like pushing 240, 230, 230. I haven't weighed myself. I need new batteries for my scale. But I should be like at that 230 range, give or take 10 pounds. I should be consuming closer to like maybe 225, 250 grams of protein. But a minimum of 200, you know. That's just me. I like to get higher to 300 grams, but man, that's a lot of protein, man. I basically need to start having a pound of beef every meal. And I'm honestly getting close to that. Like, I'm getting like 12 ounces, 10 ounces, sometimes pushing 13, 14 ounces. And I'm getting closer. And that's just for one meal. I'm not lying. That's just for one meal. But, yeah. Man, I'm sleepy now.